The servants, potential disciples, are being told to be humble. They need to know what a disciple is. And we may assume that each group believes that a true follower of Jesus looks like them. But that is for Jesus to decide. And Matthew knows it will be either one side or the other. Jesus begins with a different basic assumption. We tend to think that our call is to be the best version of ourselves. But the true Christian call is to become more and more like Jesus. I often wonder what my 20-year-old self would make of the present me. Frankly, I do not think I would have been much impressed with the younger and very much mini me. Growth is the benevolence of time. The reference today shows clearly the need for patience. A Christian is not born in a day, but forged throughout a lifetime. Human life is characterized by fits and starts, offering wanderings and dead ends. How many of us would want to be judged as the final word during a middle-aged crisis? Sanctity is on God's timetable, not ours. We need enough imagination to be surprised. Jesus does not ask our permission to reveal what he wants, whenever he wants, to whomever he wants. It is well called the God of surprises. The farm worker at least will know how we should look, but the disciples cannot be as certain. God's imagination is infinite. We are always playing catch-up. To continue the analogy, the farm worker might discover that there are many varieties of wheat, but the disciple will certainly discover that God is praised in diversity. The need for these virtues is most obvious when there is strife or division, but they are always relevant. Before the pandemic, St. Charles Church was going along splendidly. I do not remember a time in my life when everything clicked so perfectly. Then we went on lockdown. Whatever the new normal is, it will be so different that I think we are speaking not of a reopening, but of a refounding. At the very least, we know that the general understanding of the Eucharist is for most of us rather underdeveloped. We need to provide, as a church community, many more options of prayer. We will need humility. I do not think that anyone can tell us what our parish will look like this time next year. We should refrain from creating too many mental pictures and limit ourselves to the basic building blocks of Christian community. Word, sacrament, charity. Without these, we know there will be no harvest. We will need patience. We will not see many familiar faces for any number of reasons. These will include people who we might expect to show leadership. Something will grow, and we will learn hope, but it will take time. Most of all, we will need imagination. The clergy shortage is forcing change on us with or without crisis. But it always seems to be just over the horizon. The horizon is now behind us, and we must work accordingly. This will include not only the inevitable and expected broadening of leadership and development and finance, but as we have seen during the lockdown, lay leadership in prayer and worship. Our aim must not be that St. Charles resemble our memories of it, however pleasant, but that it reflects God's kingdom, however